Hey kids, and welcome to Creative Studio Storytime. My name is Connor, and today I'm going to be reading not one, but two of my favourite stories. I hope you like them as much as I do. The first story I'm going to read you is called The Tiger Who Came to Tea, and it's written by Judith Kerr. Once, there was a little girl called Sophie, and she was having tea with her mummy. In the kitchen, suddenly there was a ring at the door. Sophie's mummy said, "I wonder who that can be. It can't be the milkman, because he came this morning. And it can't be the boy from the grocer, because this isn't the day he comes. And it can't be Daddy, because he's got his key. We'd better open the door and see. Who do you think that could be?" Sophie opened the door, and there was a big, furry, stripy tiger. The tiger said, "Excuse me, but I'm very hungry. Do you think I could have tea with you?" Sophie's mother said, "Of course you can. Come in." So the tiger came into the kitchen and sat down at the table. What an unexpected guest that is. Sophie's mother said, "Would you like a sandwich?" But the tiger didn't take just one sandwich. He took all of the sandwiches on the plate and swallowed them in one big mouthful. And he still looked very hungry. So Sophie passed him the buns. But again, the tiger didn't eat just one bun. He ate all of the buns on the dish. And then he ate all of the biscuits and all of the cakes, until there was nothing left to eat on the table. Gosh, where are my manners? Sophie's mother said, "Would you like a drink?" And the tiger drank all of the milk in the milk jug and all of the tea in the teapot. And then he carried on to look around the kitchen to see what else he could find. He ate all the supper that was cooking in the saucepans, and all of the food in the fridge, and all of the packets of tins in the cupboard. God, he has such a big appetite. And he drank all of the milk, and all of the orange juice, and all of Daddy's beers, and all of the water in the tap. Then he said, "Thank you for my nice tea. I think I'd better go now." And he went. Sophie's mummy said, "I don't know what to do. I've got nothing for Daddy's supper, and the tiger has eaten it all." And Sophie found she couldn't have her bath because the tiger had drunk all of the water in the tap. Just then, Sophie's daddy came home. So Sophie and the mummy told him what had happened and how the tiger had eaten all of the food and drunk all of the drink. And Sophie's daddy said, "I know what we'll do. I've got a very good idea. We'll put on our coats and go to the cafe. I do love to go to the cafe." So they went out in the dark, and all the street lights were lit, and all the cars had their lights on, and they walked down the road to the cafe. And they had a lovely supper with sausages and chips and ice cream. In the morning, Sophie and her mummy went shopping, and they bought lots more things to eat. And they also bought a very big tin of tiger food, in case the tiger should come to tea again. But he never did. The end. I think this story has made me quite hungry, actually. I might just go ahead and grab a sandwich or two. We'll be right back with another story of my choice.